numbers, but to the beeline.
Need a bit more testing to find out.
It's actually to the right on point there. Sorry, this is a drag point. I've also got several 4 points, two of the very trailing widest points.
I've tightened up the back bridling to the tail so that it's lower down and balanced to the fore of the bridle. It seems to be holding better with it underneath the kite, having that control. Well, the weather is foul and there's the kite still up. Yeah, don't want to keep my phone out in this.
Okay, that kite is taking a hammering up there today. It's doing good. I think tighter on the underslinging would be better. It's still not got quite enough signal from that. Turbulent wind field today. It's fantastic. There's quite a bit of weighting underneath. A lot of drag. Big. Oh, that strap's come off. I had quite a lot of weighting. That might be why it's so jumpy. The tripod effort has been helping a lot. I'm going to go get that weight back on there. It's just hitting pockets and pockets. It's hardly up at all, but there's so many lumps coming through, it's just incredible. So yeah, we're only, what's that? Maximum about 15 meters off the ground. After that, there's a line that goes right over to this high drag tail, an elastic part of the end, and a heavy strap at the back of that. Now, there's only that one connection point to ground, right there. It is spread over a much larger area, so the location where the kite can be is much reduced. So it doesn't gather so much speed across the wind when it starts going off, but it's a hugely turbulent wind field, right? So, with only being one connection down to this wide area, it hasn't got the rotational stability. It takes surges and pulses and will still crash. It could still loop round. Yeah, you can have really fine controls on there to hold it. And it wouldn't take much to do that. It just takes little tweaks on those back lines to steer it. It's all still one point at the moment and just not enough. You need, you know, references. If you can do that passively with a wheel at that point and a wheel at that point and a line tension straight down it so that, you know, the mounting is very much on that wheel and it's always looking at a flat plane, yeah, that'd be great. You can probably get away with doing it passively, but single point kites, you know, they suck. Yeah, doing it passively, it wouldn't be single anymore. You know, you'd have that wheel, you'd have it, you know, cutting halfway up that bridling. And that'd be your reference, you'd hold that quite flat. Hey, by the way, lovely bit of sun coming through. First bit today. It's been really wild. But yeah, lulls and just holes. Absolutely so turbulent. So I've crossed over. Giving a line there as a reference to where it's going.
Let's see.